that we're going to do now is a complete meal that's going to be cooked in the Thermomix, and we're going to take advantage of the varoma. And I think the varoma is something that's probably underutilized by people because they just don't realize how practical it is, how good it is from a nutritional point of view, because when we steam the food, we lock in all of those really good nutrients. And one of the really good things with it is there's just so little washing up when we're using this. So what we've got here is really a meal for two, and we've got some vegetables in here which I've chopped up. So we've got some beetroot, we've got some broccoli, some carrot and some leeks. So they're some of my favourite vegetables. Great colours, we're getting lots of good nutrients in there and really great flavours as well. On top of that, we put on the top shelf of the varoma. So this means we can separate the foods and we can get more foods in. And I've got two beautiful pieces of salmon. So we're using salmon as the protein food here. And both of these are about a 200 gram salmon steak. So they're a nice big salmon steak. So salmon is a great fish because it's full of these omega-3 fats and it's a lean protein. So it's a really good nutritious food and it steams really well. So I'm just gonna layer those on top. One of the things where I'll do is just put a little bit of olive oil on and just run that olive oil underneath as well, because this helps it to stop it sticking. Just give it a little massage top and bottom. Wash my hands quickly. I'm going to put a little bit of paprika on top of the salmon steaks. That just cooks in lovely flavour and it's great colour. A little pinch of salt. And the salt will cook through onto the vegetables. And then I'm putting some asparagus on top. So the way to plan the use of the varoma is that the vegetables are the things that you're steaming that cook, that take the longer to cook, you put them at the bottom. And the foods that are a little bit more delicate, like the salmon and the asparagus, if we were putting mange tout or beans on top, then they'd go on top there. Then we put the lid on. So that's good to go. That's as easy as that. We're also going to take advantage while we've got the varoma going, and we're going to use a mixture of quinoa and rice as the carbohydrate source for this meal. So I've already weighed out 150 grams of basmati rice. I'm using basmati rice because it's got a lower glycemic index than normal rice, so it's more slowly absorbed, and the flavour you get from basmati rice I really like. So I'm just going to weigh the quinoa, so I'll just zero the scales. I'm just going to put in 150 grams. One of the reasons why I mix the quinoa and rice together is because you get really good texture, really good flavours, and again, we're getting a variety within the nutrition. Now, this will only take about 15 minutes to cook, and the whole steaming takes about 25 minutes. So what I'll be doing is, first of all, setting it for 10 minutes, and then once it's cooked for 10 minutes on the varoma, I'm going to pour in the steaming basket. For the varoma to work, I need to put water in here, so I've put about 1.2 litres. So you can see on the graduations within the bowl, the 1 litre mark and the 2 litre mark. So I've just gone over that 1 litre mark. And this is just cold water that I've put in here. It will quickly boil. So I'll add the varoma to that. Temperature wise, we take it right to the top and we can see it says the varoma. And then speed, we just put it on to stir. And off it goes. So the varoma's been cooking for 10 minutes, so now it's time for me to add the rice and quinoa. Take off the varoma, take off the lid. I'm gonna use the special attachment on the spatula, on the steaming basket. Just pop that in there, nice and easy. Then put on my lid. Re-put the varoma. Just gonna add a couple of pieces of lime in with this, just to give it a nice zesty flavour. And off we go. So So the varoma's just finished, so everything, if we've timed it right, will be cooked to perfection. And you have to be quite quick once it's finished cooking because it's still steaming, it's still gonna be cooking the vegetables. So if we just leave it to stand, things will become overcooked. So I'll just take this off and be very careful when you raise the lid because there's steam coming through there. So you have to be really quite careful with that. I can see that the rice and quinoa is cooked to perfection. Use this to bring it out. Look at that, that's absolutely fantastic. So just put this in there, and some of the colouring from the beetroot has come through. We'll just stir all of this in nice and gently so we can see all the rice and quinoa together. Just take the lid off. The salmon looks fantastic. The smells that are coming through are great, very zesty with the lime. Let's take off my asparagus. The smells are great, and this is just cooked to perfection. It's not overcooked at all. We can see that the salmon's cooked beautifully. Nothing has stuck. Put them across there, take them off the tray, and again we've got some absolutely fantastically cooked beets, broccoli, carrots and leeks. So not only is that a beautiful meal, it's a really nutritious meal. Not only is it fit for a king, it'd be fit for a champion. And then to go with this, we've got the tomato sauce that we made earlier. I'll just actually just pour a little bit along the bottom. And then that's ready to go.
So talk to me about steaming versus steaming your vegetables or steaming your food. Why does it really make a difference?
So steaming, a couple of things with it. First of all, when you boil vegetables, then it's in a large volume of water, and a lot of the nutrients, a lot of the vitamins leach out, so you're losing a lot of them because the water's soluble. So if it's in that bath, then it sucks out a lot of the vitamins. So what you should really do, if you boil vegetables, you should drink the water from it. You should use that, which a lot of us don't do. So you're actually losing it. And with steaming, the steam really helps to lock in those nutrients. So you lose much less, you know, so it's really retaining. And from a cooking point of view, the way that it cooks the vegetables are a little bit different. The steaming is not quite as aggressive as boiling. So what you find is that the vegetables retain a better structure than if you boil them. We'll all remember when we were kids and we go to his granny's for Sunday dinner and she'd been, you know, cooking the cauliflower for a week in the pan and it was just mush. So we don't get that when we steam it. We really keep that structure and we keep the nutrients. So from a fish point of view, or a chicken or a meat perspective, then again, if we steam it, it helps to retain that some of the nutrients, but we don't lose quite as much from meat because the nutrients tend to be locked within the cells of the meat. But from a cooking point of view, it's a nice gentle cooking. So if we overcook, so let's say we fry chicken or we fry meat or we fry fish, then if we overcook it, then that denatures the protein, so we can't digest it quite as easily. So really, from the steaming point of view, it helps to retain the integrity and structure of the food.
And the advantage, obviously, here with the Thermomix is that it's cooking. You've got your meal, your complete meal.
Yeah, all absolutely. In one. So that's absolutely correct. So the Thermomix is steaming the salmon, steaming the vegetables, and at the same time, it's cooking the rice and quinoa. So we get it all done together. Perfect. Saving on electric, saving on time, saving on washing up. Mm-hmm.